Hello there! To improve the performance of Stable Diffusion, there are a few Windows-specific things you can do. You can disable the GPU scheduling feature. Search for Graphics Settings in the Windows search bar. Click on Change Default Graphics Settings. Deactivate Hardware-Accelerated GPU Scheduling. Restart your PC. It is also possible to turn off browser hardware acceleration. Open the browser you are using your Stable Diffusion WebUI with, go to Settings, click on System and Performance. Turn off hardware acceleration. Restart your browser. By increasing the power budget of your GPU, you can also increase its performance. Open up your GPU control utility. For Nvidia, that is the Nvidia Control Panel. Click on Manage 3D Settings, scroll down to Power Management Mode. Select Prefer Maximum Performance from the drop-down menu. Make sure you click on the Apply button in the bottom right-hand corner of the window. To further improve performance, you can use command line arguments for automatic 1111. To edit these, go into your Stable Diffusion directory. If you are on a Windows system, edit the file webuser.bat. Edit the webuser.shell file if you're on WSL2 or Linux. If you're on Windows and you can't edit the webuser.bat file, change the file extensions to a .txt file extension and make it editable. To display the file extensions, click on View, Show, File Extensions. Simply rename the file and open it. Enter the command line arguments after the set command line args line. I will edit the webuser.shell file because my automatic 1111 runs on WSL2. Remove the hashtag to uncomment the export line. I have included the links to the documentation of these commands in the description. Note that medvram and lowvram are often recommended, but they generate images slowly, with the advantage of using less memory. If you're looking for speed and don't want to generate images in native high resolutions, you might not want to use them. These are my personal settings for a GTX 1060. I'll just put them there. This is what it will look like for Windows. If you have a Tensor GPU, I suggest you use opt channels last. Depending on what you want to do, read the documentation to personalize your command line arguments. After you've saved the file, restart automatic 1111. In the prompt window, you will see that it is installing xformers, if you have enabled that, and that it starts with the parameters you specified. You can benchmark your GPU to see if the set command line arguments are actually improving performance. There is a public database, I have put the link in the description. Or search the internet for SD WebUI benchmark data. You can look up your GPU and see what performance other people are getting. You can also sort by models to see which models generate the quickest. To benchmark and compare your GPU, go to your WebUI, click on Extensions and click on Available. Search for System. The System Info extension will show up. Click on Install. Go back to the Installed section. Check if the SD extension System Info is there. Click on Apply and Restart UI to activate the extension. When your UI is restarted, there is a new System Info tab. It shows information about your GPU, which platform you're on, which libraries are installed, and so on. Scroll down a bit to see the benchmark section. Click on Run Benchmark to test your GPU. I'll use the extensive benchmark level to benchmark all batch sizes. It reports the iterations per second for the batch sizes 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16 depending on your chosen benchmark level. If you choose normal, it will test for the batch sizes 1, 2 and 4. If you choose extensive, it will additionally benchmark the sizes 8 and 16. This can be interesting if you notice that your GPU performs better at higher batch sizes. If you want to note something, you can do so by entering that in the note field. For example, if you have overclocked your GPU. After clicking on Run Benchmark, you can check the status in the console window. It will show total progress when it's done. It shows all the stats in the web UI. Click on Submit Results to share them with the community, so other people can look at yours and see how they can improve. In the performance column are the iterations per second for each of the batch sizes starting with batch size 1. If you compare your results to others, you may notice that other command line arguments work better. I personally ran this twice and noticed that if I do not use the --.medvram as a startup argument, my GPU generates the images about 0.3 iterations faster. After a bit of testing, I use these parameters now on a GTX 1060.